Good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Saurabh Roy. So in this presentation, we'll discuss about one essay index article, which was published in Wireless Personal Communication. The work is based on mutual coupling reduction in a multiband MIMO antenna using meta-inspired decoupling network. So here in this structure, a meta structures or meta-inspired decoupling network structures are used to reduce the mutual coupling between two antennas. Okay. So that structure is designed in the wearable technology, or we can see that wearable material which are used for designing the antenna structure. So first we'll see the introduction or available technology in clinical trial. So wearable technology is nowadays used in different services like military services, fire department and medical application. The antenna requirement in wearable technology is quite different to the conventional counterpart, because in the wearable technology, when we are used in the antenna, we have seen that we are used in different position, like near to the hand or near to the heart, then footwear or eyes. So those are different positions. So here we have seen, if we'll use the technology in different position, and sometimes also we are using the bioimplantable cases. So the human body is a lossy material. So whenever we are using different position like hand, then wrist, then chest, so based on the bending also affected, because different human body different human body bending structure or carving structure patterns are different. Okay, so many things are comes into consideration. So wearable technology is very quite challenging task whenever we are using the wearable technology. So first we choose the substrate which is the wearable substrate, and we are used the wearable technology by using MIMO wearable antenna, and we are trying to reduce the mutual coupling between two elements. So MIMO technology, which has multiple input, multiple output antenna. So instead of single antenna, two or multiple antennas are used to improve the space diversity, performance enhancement, and channel gain, channel capacity, channel bandwidth, and data transmission. So here we have observed that in the MIMO cases, the minimum multipath threading can be accomplished with MIMO antenna. But the problem is, whenever we have seen the multiple antenna we are using at a time, so in that time, due to using multiple antenna at a time, so one antenna radiation will affect the other antenna. You can see that if two person is speak at a time, okay, then the third person or one person noise will affect the other person. So similar cases in the radiation cases also, the one antenna radiated and another antenna is near of, if it's far field or near field, then that antenna, due to this antenna radiation, another antenna radiation performance will be affected. Now to reduce those things, we are using mutual coupling, we are using some different techniques we are accomplished. So here we are using the meta inspired decoupling network structure, which reduce the mutual coupling between two antennas. So first we analyze the substrate, because substrate is our, normally we are using different substrate which are available, but in this case we are using the jeans substrate material, which are using cloth material. Okay, so for analysis purpose, for cloth material we are using backter network analyzer and dielectric assessment kit for analysis this particular cloth substrate. Okay. So then we can finalize the exact permeability, loss tangent and dielectric properties of the material. So this purpose, actually we done that analysis by using dielectric assessment kit and backter network analyzer. Okay. So in the next phase, we'll design a MIMO antenna which has two element. So here we have seen the two element antenna, that's MIMO antenna. So the structures of the MIMO antenna is shown there. So here we are using this partial ground structure. Okay. So we observed that our antenna is worked from near about 1.6 to 3.9 and 4.1 to 6 gigahertz. Okay, but the problem is whenever same cases, same the antenna suffers this S12, or one antenna radiation is affected the other antenna, or isolation problem. So here we observe that isolation is near about 2.5 gigahertz, the isolation is minus 10 dB. Similarly, in the other cases, isolation is very poor. Okay, so so to improve the isolation performance of the antenna, so here we are using a metamaterial inspired structure, or metamaterial unit cell inspired structure, which will use as a decoupling network in between two elements. Okay, so we done the analysis of metamaterial performance actually. So here the performance is, so we observed that it has S parameter we extracted by using metamaterial analysis or periodic cell analysis. Now we found that it shown negative permeability in the lower region as well in the this 5.1 to 5.6 region. Okay, so we have seen that it shown negative permeability in the lower region as well as upper region. So due to negative permeability, we know the value of n equal to root over mu and epsilon. So it will, one is the negative, here mu is negative, so due to the mu and value is negative, so it will stop that particular band. Okay, so that is the one metamaterial properties, k equal to, so it we are using as a stop band behavior. Okay, so to reduce the coupling between the antenna elements. So first we use two different unit cell in the upper part. So this top layer, top is indicated by yellow and bottom is indicated by another color. Okay, so first step we analyze the unit cell in the top layer, in the second part we analyze the unit cell in the bottom, and in the last or final stage we put the unit cell in the both layer, in the ground layer, bottom layer as well as top layer. Now we, what is the effect of the unit? So MIMO antenna 4 is our final antenna. So we observe that S parameter performance, it shows quite, it shows performance in the lower band as well as upper band. So there are some distortion is there. So due to metamaterial unit cell we are using, so S parameter performance is slightly affected, but it is below less than 10, minus 10 dB. So now if we'll observe the S12 performance, then where here we can see that drastically changes. Okay, because in S12 cases, whenever you see the mutual coupling or isolation, so isolation performance is improved. So in the lower band as well as our upper band. So here we'll see the stepwise MIMO antenna 2, 3 and 4. So in the every stage, so here our main motto is improve the isolation performance in 2.4 gigahertz, 5.2 gigahertz as well as 5.8 gigahertz, because those three frequency are used for wireless LAN applications. So here we are trying to improve the performance in these three frequency only. Now for clarify the vision, so how the things are observed. So here we'll see at three different frequency. So whenever we apply the surface current distribution, we have seen that those shown effective performance, means in the low frequency as well as 2.4, 5.2 and 5.8 gigahertz, it blocks the particular current. So that's the current pattern you can observe in there. Similarly, if you see the comparison between MIMO antenna 1 and MIMO antenna 4, so that comparison we can see clearly what is the actual reason. So here you have seen in the S11 performance also improved in the higher band. Apart from that, if you see the S12 performance, then you can observe sharply that isolation performance is improved sharply at near about 20 dB in the 5.2 gigahertz as well as more of 5.8 gigahertz. And similarly, it improved the performance as 2.4 gigahertz. Now, if you see the other MIMO parameter like ECC or envelope correlation coefficient and diversity gain, so here we have seen, observed that comparison of MIMO antenna 1 and MIMO antenna 4. So the performance is less than 0.01 in the cases of MIMO antenna 4 or our final stage. So this performance is good in our we are considering 2.4 as well as 5 to 6 gigahertz band, 5.2 and 5.8 gigahertz. So in that particular cases, our ECC and DG or MIMO performance is very effective. Now coming to the fabrication. So we have done manually, we have done the fabrication by using copper tap, which is available in Amazon. And after fabrication, we measured it. So here we have seen the top view as well as bottom view of the fabricated prototype. Okay, so now in the next phase, we are using antenna element 1. Here we will see the antenna element 1, and here you can see the antenna element 2. So this is the equivalent circuit of the this overall antenna or MIMO antenna 4. So these two are here. These two patch layer decoupling element and these three are ground layer decoupling element. So this part is used for the basically for the feeding structure, similar type, and both antenna has similar structure. So this is the complex equivalent circuit of the parameter of the MIMO antenna cases. Okay, so in the result and analysis part, here we will see how the MIMO antenna in simulated and measured result, and we have done comparison between simulated and measured cases. So comparison of S11, S12, as well as we found the gain comparison of MIMO antenna 4 in simulated and measured course. So here we have observed that in the simulated as well as measurement cases, the antenna shows quite good performance in both cases. And this is the radiation pattern or EH plane radiation pattern at 2.4 GHz and 5.2 GHz. So here it is observed that in the particular direction or due to coupling network, the beam is slightly shifted in, or there is a losses is very or no radiation radiated in this particular direction. All the radiation is radiated in opposite way of the coupling structure. Okay. So this is the overall comparison table. So we found the maximum of 20 dB isolation enhancement in this particular structure with gap is inter-element gap input 13.5 mm. Okay. So we improved the isolation of in multiple frequency in 2.4, 5.2 and 5.8 GHz, and two element MIMO antenna isolation techniques also we checked. So in these cases, so this article is published in Wireless Parcel Communication in 2020. And thank you.